Wednesday nights, we're normally praying. We're going to have some worship tonight and a word from the Lord. Good to see you. Those of you who are even visiting tonight from near and far, I know I've got a friend here all the way from the other side of Chapalaya, so I'm glad to see everybody. How many of you glad to be in the house of the Lord tonight? Amen. If you're watching, we welcome you into our service. You can DM us or let us know, because we'll be praying, we'll be calling out prayer requests. We're already receiving them tonight. I want you to just lift your hands to God. He's an awesome God. And we just want to welcome him together. Father, we just thank you tonight as we enter your presence with thanksgiving, your courts with praise. We're thankful unto you. We bless your name because it's your name, Lord God, that drives away all fear and doubt. Your name that heals the sick. Your name that even raises the dead. And so we expect you to show up and show out tonight in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, in Jesus' name, amen. Now come on, clap your hands for him. Put your hands together like this. Come on.
Water, you turned into wine. Open the eyes of the blind. Into the dark. God is here.
Stretch your hands to heaven if you believe it tonight.
Our God is stronger. God, you are mighty. Oh, you are greater. Our God is omnipotent. Awesome in power, our God. Our God. Oh, and if our God is for us, ever stop
us. You believe it tonight? Do you believe it tonight? So declare with us, say,
and if our God is for us,
say it,
then who could ever stop us?
If our God is with us. Declare one more time, say,
and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us,
what?
Then what can stand against
us?
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us,
it's a Wednesday night, you can get lost in his presence. Whatever you feel in the presence of the Lord, if you want to get on your knees tonight, you want to approach the altar, just find a way to pour it out to him. No bright lights on a Sunday morning, no cameras of a Sunday morning, but just you and God, you and him tonight.
There's nothing that can stand in your face.
We thank you, God. We thank you for your presence in this place. We thank you for your presence in our lives, God. We thank you because if you be for us, who can be against us? Hallelujah. We just finished saying, if God be for us, if God be for us, it doesn't matter what's against us. It doesn't matter who's against us. It doesn't matter what's in front of us. It doesn't matter what's coming up behind us. If he be for us, nothing else matters. Hallelujah. Give him glory. Give him glory. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. God, we bless your name tonight. We bless your name tonight. We lift you high tonight. We give you glory tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise you because you're worthy of praise. Anybody believe he's worthy of praise? Anybody believe he's worthy to be praised? I don't think we just showed up on Wednesday night just to check a block. I don't think we showed up just to check it off and say, okay, we here. We here. If you hear, he's worthy. Glory. Hallelujah. If you got breath in your body, he's worthy. Anybody breathing tonight? Anybody breathing tonight? Hallelujah. God, we thank you. We give you glory and we honor you. We welcome you to Wednesday Night Live. Those of you who are streaming as well, we welcome you. We ask you to get in a space where you can usher in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We thank you for what you're doing in this place. We thank you. This is a participatory prayer. Hallelujah. You can participate in praying to the God, to our Father. You can participate in lifting your voices, for he's worthy of it, God. Father, we give you praise tonight. We give you glory tonight. We thank you for all that you've done today and before today, God. We realize that anything could happen, could have happened on our way here, but you saw fit to bring us here. Man, we came here, Lord, with expectation. If you brought us here, you want to say something to us. If you brought us here, it's something that we need to hear. So, God, we give you glory, and we ask that you speak to our hearts tonight. We don't want to leave here the same way we came. We don't want to leave here with the same mindset, hallelujah. We don't want to leave here with the same heart, God. We want you to speak to us so that when we leave this place, we will leave thinking different. We will leave believing different, God. We will believe expecting different. Hallelujah. God, we give you glory. I'm going to read Psalms 151 through 6, and this is the NLT. It says, praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heaven. Praise him for his mighty works. Praise his unequal greatness, which means there's no other greatness that can be compared to him. No rival. Hallelujah. Nothing compares to him. He is matchless. Hallelujah. Praise him with a blast of the ram's horn. Praise him with the lyre and harp. Praise him with the tambourine and dancing. Praise him with strings and flutes. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with loud clanging cymbals. Let everything that breathes. Anybody breathing in here tonight? Let everything that breathes. Anybody got breath in their body tonight? Let everything that breathes sing praises to the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let me hear you praise God. Let me hear you praise God. The word says if you got breath in your body, the word says if you can breathe, if you're breathing, you ought to give me glory. If birds can fly, they're giving me glory because they're doing what I created them to do. If the trees waver in the wind, they give me glory because when the wind blows, they move. When I open my mouth as a worshiper, I give you glory, God. So we come tonight lifting you high. We come tonight with no other agenda. We come tonight with our minds and our hearts open. We come tonight wanting to hear a word from you and believing that you're going to speak to our hearts. We ask that you have your way in this place, God. Do what you do. Do what you do because you're mighty. You're sovereign. You're omnipotent. You're omnipresent. You're Jehovah. You're Jehovah Jireh. You are El Shaddai. You are Jehovah Shalom. You are everything that we need, God. So we give you glory for being all of that and some. Hallelujah. God, we bless your name. We ask that you have your way in this place. We thank you. thank you for the word that will come forth tonight. We thank you for the anointing that rests upon the one who will deliver. And we ask that you have your way in this place. Move everything out of the way that's in between us and you. Move everything out of the way that hinders us from hearing your word. Move everything out of the path that hinders us from obeying your word. Have your way in this place, God. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, amen. You can take your seats. You may take your seats. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Again, we welcome you. We welcome you. We welcome you here this evening to Wednesday Night Live. I'm Minister Renee. I'm going to read the announcements and let you know what is going on here at LFC. Amen. So we welcome you here as our guests. In the seat back in front of you, there's a connect card that looks like this. If you would fill this out, this allows us to be a blessing to you. So please fill it out. You can put it in the buckets in the back corners of the sanctuary, or you can turn it in at the connection desk. You can also download the LFC Church app to connect further and access sermon messages. Amen. Keys to Freedom Women Freedom Study. Keys to Freedom Women Free. Any women in here free? Any women in here continuously living free? Amen. I will final meeting for this study. The last part of Keys to Freedom will be Monday, this coming Monday, May 8th at 6:30 here in the sanctuary. This has been an incredible journey, and we can't wait to finish with you Monday night. We will be discussing key 7, maintaining lifelong freedom in Christ. Amen. All right. Champion Men Breakfast. Okay, I'm going to do it again. Champion Men Breakfast. Okay, all right. Men, our Champion Men Breakfast is held on the first and third Tuesday morning of each month from 6:30 to 7:30 a.m. Their next meeting will be Tuesday, May 16th at Brown Skillet, and that's at 519 South Pierce Street. Invite someone to come and make plans to join the men as iron sharpens iron. The word says, so one man sharpens another. Amen. And I would like to invite you to join us right back here on Sunday morning for our 10 o'clock service, our Sunday worship experience, and again, invite someone to come. Amen. That's the end of our announcements. We'll have the offering message by Ranger.
All right. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, saints. All right. This is a time and service where is everyone can participate if you would like to do so. I have one Bible verse. I'm going to come from Romans 12 and 6 NIV. We have different gifts according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophecy, then prophesy in accordance with your faith. The great thing about giving, when you give, you don't just give. There's something about giving and being a blessing to others, and it's better to give than to receive. How many people know that God has blessed you with something? Everybody got something. I mean, I'm country, that's something, right? Something. You were born with something. The great thing about when we give that, it can help, especially in the kingdom, multiply, do other things. We have a ministry here where we give to the pregnancy center, and you may not see that here, but that happens. That helps women. That helps people in this community. And I'm going to give you the ways that you can give, and then I'm going to pray. And afterwards, if you would like to give, if you brought something here to give you in person, like a check or something like that, or any finances, you can take it to the back. We have some buckets back in the back corners on the left and right, and I'll let you know when you can do that. There's also offering envelopes behind the seats, and you can give online at www.lfclafayette.com. You can click to give that way, or you can text to give at give to 888-364-4483, or you can go onto the church app and give that way, or you can mail your gift to P.O. Box 61132, Lafayette, Louisiana, 70596. Or you can bring it here to the church in person at 1300 Bertrand Drive, Lafayette, Louisiana. Our phone number is 337-261-8801. And our email It's info@lfclafayette.com. We're also active on all of our social media platforms, and we have an all-in campaign where we believe in God for a new building, another facility, an improved place to worship and serve Him. So what I'm going to do right now is pray, and if you do have an offering and you would like to give, afterwards you feel free to stand up and take it to the back, and you can put it in the buckets in the back. So let's pray. God, we thank you right now for this offering. We bless you for what we're about to receive. We're just excited also for the ministry tonight of Coach Reggie. We thank you for this time. In Jesus' name, amen. You may give.
Great to see everybody tonight. My heart is filled with so much joy tonight. There's a dear person here that I don't know if this is your first time. Is it your first time here? Okay. It's first time here tonight. We've been knowing one another for so many years. I give away some of my age. I mean, my earliest memory of John Sims is seeing him. I'm playing the organ and I'm seeing him watching. And everybody who knows him, he's got one of the most powerful, humble spirits on him. And I can just see him off in the cut just watching, you know, while I was playing the organ probably 30 years ago, something like that, you know, 35 years ago. And then lo and behold, I mean, he becomes one of the best musicians in Baton Rouge. When I tell you he can play the devil off you, he get on the keyboard or organ, and you think Jesus sitting up there playing. And just been a dear friend. He's been a part of my ministry for so many years. My first recording, live recording I did in Baton Rouge, he was a part of that. And just been a part of so many different things we've done together. He's here with a teaching assignment. I think they have testing this week. And this is something he comes to Lafayette to do from Baton Rouge every year. But I just wanted to take the time for you, Lighthouse, to help me thank God for John Sims. Wave your hand, John. Okay. Amen. Well, I tell you what, I don't know, man. I might have to get you on them keys before we get out of here. I told the church Sunday, I said, boy, y'all better be glad I ain't got no organist, boy. Y'all remember that? Yeah, and y'all got with me, boy. I said, can you say amen? Y'all said, amen. I heard somebody say amen. Yeah. Y'all better be glad. I got my organist tonight. Maybe that's why the Lord said you ain't preaching tonight because you got your organist tonight. Yeah. Then secondly, I want to ask Andrew. Andrew, come. I believe that this is your last Wednesday before you leave, right? Okay. Stand right here. We're going to pray for him. At the same time, if you pray and just ask the Lord what you're to do towards the missions trip that he's going on. He's leaving this Saturday. Okay. We'll be praying over Gabby next week as she leaves the next weekend. He's still believing God for the rest of his finances for the missions trip. We're going to be cutting him a check tonight also from the church. But I want you to be prayerful about that. And if you're making out a check, you can make it out to Chi Alpha. He'll be here tonight. Maybe before you leave, if you pray and ask the Lord what part should you be taking in this venture and just be a blessing to him. But let's point your hands this way. We're going to pray over him. Now you're going to where? Costa Rica. So, Father, we just thank you for Andrew. We thank you for how you've drawn his heart, how we've seen him grow and just in leaps and bounds and strengthened over these months. And as he's pursued you, you've prepared him for such a time as this. So we just thank you, Father, as he goes to Costa Rica with a team, that you're going to protect them. We speak and plead the blood of Jesus over them. We pray that the ministry opportunities on those streets and those places you prepared them to go, that you said if we go, that you would follow us with signs and wonders, that signs and wonders would follow, that he would heal the sick, Lord God, he would cast out demons, Father, that the power of God would rest upon them. So we just thank you that as they declare it and they speak it, you'll manifest your word by your spirit. And we thank you for the harvest. We thank you for them coming back with an incredible report. As he comes back to our church to testify and to talk about what happened, I just thank you, Lord. We thank you that he's going to come back with a great report. Bless him, Father, and thank you that all the needs that he has will be met and plenty more for him to use to bless them. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody say, in Jesus' name, amen. Come on, shout at Andrew. Say, go, Andrew. All right. Well, I don't want to take any more time up. I thank God for the man of God tonight that will be coming to speak to us. We are totally excited. As a team, we've been praying all day because we know whenever God uses this man of God, it's so impactful. It's so applicable to our lives. It's not high and not over our heads, but it just hits us right in the heart. And I know most of you should know this man because his reputation far exceeds the church walls. Just an incredible sports person, mentor of men, sharing and mentoring and discipling men through sports, through training, for years, pro athletes in the leagues. Many of them refer to their mentoring and their stability and their foundation through this man of God. And then, of course, he was sent to Lafayette, and then we have been blessed by him. Our family personally has been blessed by him, my sons. And as I look out in the audience, I see his beautiful wife. Thank God for you being here tonight, Sister Shakitha. Why don't you clap your hands for her being here tonight? We love you. I tell you what, can't nobody cheer from the stands like that woman right there, boy. Wherever she at, in the corner of the stadium, whatever, you're going to know she's there, you know, because that's a Falk voice right there. We know about that. And then I look in and I see many of you who are here, and you're the fruit of his ministry, and many of you have a testimony that you're blessed. So I won't take any more time up. I'm going to ask him to come and bless us tonight. Why don't you do this, honor this man of God, stand on your feet and clap your hands as he comes, because we have been so blessed. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. To my wife, I love you. To everybody that's here, thank you. To my brothers, man, from the father and son Bible study, I love you all, man. Can't wait to get back to it. Just want to pray, man. Father God, I just come right now, Father God, that Jesus will live through me, speak through me, Father God, that it won't be about me and my senses or my reasoning, but your Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, you're welcome here. The angels of the Lord, you're welcome here. And I bless you for this opportunity, Lord God, that you use me, a vessel like me, just to come, Father God. Your kingdom is at hand in this place right now, Lord God. We decree it in Jesus' name, amen. I'm about to put this thing down anyway. Father God, what I want y'all to do is just repeat after me. Say, Father God, we come in Jesus' name, decreeing that everything that the cankerworm has stolen from us spiritually, physically, mentally, and financially be released to us right now in Jesus' name. And Father God, we ask you that everything that's spoken tonight will fall on good ground. In Jesus' name, amen. As I toiled around with what God wanted me to speak tonight, I just simply asked him, God, just to speak to me what I need and what your people need. And God brought me to a story that I read, man, and it was about this Christian family who lost their daughter to a drunk driver. They hit her and she died. So they went to court, they sued, and they sued for $1.5 million, and they were awarded that $1.5. But they told the judge, we don't want the $1.5. We want him to write out a check for $1 every week because we want him to remember what he did. It's a Christian family. Now, here's the way you got to look at that. Christian family. And it's going to go into what God wants me to say. First of all, they kept themselves from releasing their child. So they kept themselves in torment. But they also did the same thing to the other man, because it got to a point to where he would just stop making the payments for $1. Then he went back and he sued them for pain and suffering, because it was destroying him every time he had to write that check out. And God ministered to me this week. He said, my people, the church, those of us, my children that have given their life to Christ and accepted Jesus Christ, living on the blood covenant, hold themselves and other people under the Ten Commandments. Receive that. You say, you've given your life to me, but you yourselves hold each other to the Ten Commandments, because you hold each other to perfection that you can't receive in the natural. So I say, God, what is it that you want me to speak on? He said, I want you to speak on the one thing and the only thing that you can bring to heaven with you that you'll never lose. He said, love. He said, love. And he starts showing me things that's happening in the schools and happening in society where young boys are beating up girls like they're grown men. Well, I saw a student, his teacher took his phone, and he asked the teacher for his phone. The teacher said, no, the teacher was about 65 years old. He knocked him out cold. God says, my people's hearts are void of love. So he said, I want you to allow me not only to use you to speak about love, but I'm a minister to you too. Because if God filled this room tonight with gold bars, those golden bars that may be worth $1 million still won't be as beautiful as love. There's nothing on earth that's more valuable or more beautiful than true love. True love. And it's simple. I told this to a brother today. I said, he's here. I said, Brother Tree, God has made it so simple for us. I said, and it's all surrounded around love. Had some young ladies I've trained in today. I said, if we learn to walk in love, life will get so much easier. I said, because we walk in true love. When someone hurt us, we'll say, I forgive you and I love you. I can forgive you because I love you. But the problem is that in the natural, our love have limits. But in the supernatural, love is limitless. Corinthians 13:4 say, love is patient. Love is not in a hurry to make the other person be what you want them to be. Love is patient. Just like God is patient with us. Love is kind. That no matter what you did to me or how you treated me, I'm still going to be kind to you because I love you. I hear you, Lord. God said, tell them I'm not just talking about your children, your wife, and your husband. Talking about your enemy. See, it's easy to be patient with the one that you know that loves you. But can you be patient with the one that don't love you like God is patient with us? Just think on that. Can we be patient with others that's in the midst of sin right now, that hate you right now? I hear you, God. God said, you know how on your birthday you pin that money on you? And that person in your family that you can't stand, when they pin that money on you, you don't tell them take it back. I don't know where God is going to go with this, but I'm just going to pray that he speak to me and speak through me. It says, love does not envy and is not boastful. And it goes to the scripture, God said, how dare you boast? You move, you bring, you have life because of me. If I didn't allow you to do it, you would not accomplish it. So glorify me. I love your gratitude. And the more gratitude you give me, the more I'll pour myself into you. Lord, mercy, help me, Jesus. Remember, this is for all of us. Because let me tell you something. I don't care where you are in your life right now. Everybody in here need God. Whether you're in a storm of your life, whether you got high yesterday, whether you got drunk last night, whether you was prostituting, no matter where you at or what you are, everybody in here need God. We all need our Father. It says, and it's not arrogant. You know, no disrespect. When Pastor Ty was talking about me, I want to say, shut up. Don't say that. Brother Randy, you understand? Like, man, don't, like you said, you ready? I said, man, I don't want to be here. In the flesh, in the natural, I don't want to be up here. I want the spirit. I want the spirit to rule and super rule over my soul. Where what I say, I hear from heaven. Because I want my life to be changed and I want your life to be changed. I don't want any of God's glory on me. I can wait till Jesus return to receive my glorification. Because I've already been justified. Now I'm being sanctified more and more every day. So I'll just take my sanctification. I don't need the glorification. And that's no disrespect, Pastor. But look what it says here. It says, and it's not rude. See, I used to have that problem. Well, I'm going to tell you, man, I'm just going to tell you the way it is. And I realized, God says, some people can take that like that. Even my players, some people can take me. Like I go to Melvin and say, Mel, this the way it is, bro. But then I got little John. I go tell little John something. Little John start crying on the sideline. Nobody can block him, but he start crying. So God says, you got to simmer down. Got to simmer down. It says right here, it's not irritable. You don't get all upset all quick when things don't go your way or somebody say things not just right. You don't get like you're about to take me there. I said, what you mean? I'll take you there, but I ain't going there. That's you going there. That's out of your own free will. Oh, listen to this. So God just said, everybody has their own free will. Lucifer had his own free will. I've never had this revelation like this. The angels had their own free will. Jesus had his own free will. The proof is in the pudding when he said, okay, Father, because Jesus was 100% man, but he's 100% God. But Jesus like, man, Jesus turned sissy. No disrespect to anybody, but Jesus was like, man, God, if you'll take this away from me, but not my will, your will be done. So Jesus was like, man, I'm about to bail out of this stuff, this will stuff on y'all. Because Jesus started thinking about what he was going to have to go through for us. And Jesus said, oh, Lord God, if you would only take this cup from me. But he says, no, I'm not going to do this according to my will. I'm going to do it according to your will. The rebellion, that is no rebellion in God. So God didn't put rebellion in the angels. They chose to rebel. They made a decision to rebel on their own. So God said, I got a place for you. Just like we have our own free will. We could get jumping edgy in the natural. Or we can say, God, no. That's my will. I want to say this. But love don't want to say this. Because the Bible says that God is love. Let's move on. It says, because some of y'all looking at me like, man, what Brother Reggie talking about? He says, look, whoa. Taj, you know what he says next? And he keeps no records of wrongs. Father God, let us be open and honest in here. I'm going to do what I hear. My guys are used to this. How many of us need to repent right now of holding wrongs against, keeping records of wrongs? Raise your hand. Just say, Father God, forgive me. And let your spirit uproot this out of me. In Jesus' name. Amen. And that's for me too. See, the most beautiful thing about God, what you got to understand about God's love is, he didn't just throw rocks at you. He just threw some tissue at you to get your attention. And it's like I tell the guys, it's like you go bowling and you can't bowl, so they put the little bumpers up so the ball can hit a pin. Well, that's what the Holy Spirit has been given to us for. Just to let you know, okay, you're getting outside of the lane. You're getting out of your lane. You're getting out of your spiritual lane. You're starting to go over in there in the natural and into the darkness. So I'm just reminding you to get back in. See, God don't come to hurt you, man. God said, no, I'm just trying to get your attention. I'm just sending you a warning so the adversary of your soul won't come and have to come to me and say, God, look, they're way out of line. Now what you going to let me do? But God said, I love you so much that I'm inside of you. I speak to you. I tell you to get it right. Let's move because I want to stay inside of my time. He says, look, love finds no joy in unrighteousness, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believe all things, and hope all things, and endure all things. And you find me a couple that's married that do that. You find me a powerful couple. Listen to what the Spirit just told me. That a marriage is supposed to be a witness to the world of what God is to his people. I received that, man. He said a marriage on earth, that's why I say marriage is holy. He said because your marriage between a husband and wife is supposed to let the world see what he is to us. I can prove it because I hear him. He said, I say when a man and a woman come together, they should become one. He said, when you give your life to Christ, you become one with me. You got what I'm saying? That when Jesus died, you died. When he rose, you rose. And all power that he had was now because, I got to move, man. Let me move. Let's go to Galatians, man. Let me find Galatians right quick. Galatians 5. I don't have my glasses, so y'all bear with me. I'm asking God to bless me with some better eyes. I am. That's 14, 15. What I'm looking for. It says here, look. 16, 5 and 16. I say then, walk by the Spirit. And you will certainly not carry out the desires of the flesh. For what the flesh desires, what is against the spirit, and what the spirit desires is against the flesh. These oppose each other. I'm going to get to the love. Because this, look, the Bible says that when you give your life to Christ, that Jesus quickens you. And I was like, God, what do you mean quicken? And he showed me like somebody that had died and they hit him with those prongs and they come back to life. I said, well, what are you showing me? He said, a man, when that happens, it says, though that man died and he came back to life, a new man came forth, but not a natural man, a spirit man. His spirit was then, justification came right then. That right then, God placed a spirit in you so you can be just like his son. So you can do all things just like Jesus did. But here's the thing. The two that oppose each other, the flesh still going to be there. The sin nature still going to be there. Well, what about the love part? God said, if you love me, you will obey me. So even when that sinful nature rise up, when your flesh rise up, he said, because of the love that you have for me, because I first loved you, you will obey me and say, Lord God, not my will, but your will. So I surrender, Lord God, to your will. We always hear God loved, so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. That's beautiful. Here's where God took it even deeper for me. He said, I loved you so much that I had the price paid for you when you were just a spirit around my throne. The price was paid for you before you were even in your mother's womb. That's how much I love you. That I didn't wait and have a price paid for you when you were born. That price was paid for you before you were born. And you had the opportunity to live like my son and be like my son and be like me. Even before you were born, that was already set in place. Well, how do you say that, brother? Because he says this, that we've been created in his image and his likeness, and we have his DNA. That he loved us so much, not only did he let his son die for us, but he loved us so much that he gave us his own DNA. How would you like it right now if Tyler could start shooting that thing the way you shot it when you was in college? You got what I'm saying? How would you like it if little Bryce could go and play golf the way you play it right now? Well, Jesus said, bam! Everything that I've done and even more, you can do, bam, right now. Lay hands on the sick. He said, no. Heal the sick. Cast out demons. Raise the dead. Don't pray it. Decree it. Boom, right now. Just that quick. When you say, God, I believe. That's love. That's love. All right, let's go to Galatians 5. I'm going to move on down to 22 because my time running out and I'm going to obey what God says because God's going to do something. He says, but the fruit of the Spirit, the fruit that comes with that Spirit, the sweetness that comes with that Spirit. That's some sweetness, baby girl, that comes with the Spirit. God says, when you accept Christ, and you walk in your sanctification as you become more and more and more like God, love becomes easy. Because it's, God said, I am love. He said, and if you don't love, how can you say you love me when I am love and I'm in you? So what he told me was that if you can't love, maybe you're talking with your mouth. He said, but I judge your heart. And what he's saying is, I'm not asking you to love. It's a commandment that you love. If you're heirs and joint heirs with me and my son. And as I was running today, like a clown at 12:30, running 40 bleachers and 10 hundreds, saying I'm going to beat my flesh down and I ain't going to eat because I don't want my flesh to jump up tonight. God said, ask my people the things that you've been asking me for and believing for. Is it that you don't have them because you're not me? Because you're supposed to be me. You're supposed to be love. You are supposed to be love. That's why I told you the most beautiful thing that you can ever find is love. So if we are God and we are love, why are we holding each other to the Ten Commandments? Why are we counting wrongs? You got what I'm saying? I ain't throwing no stones now. I'm just as I hear, I'm speaking. Look, it says it right here. Let me find 22 again. It says, here we go. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy. Where there's love, there's supposed to be joy. Where the Spirit is, there's supposed to be joy. Where God is, there's supposed to be joy. But be peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and Lord, for me, gentleness. And this was the biggest thing for me for most of my life, man. Self-control. Because I had none. What you want to do, bro? Want to throw hands? Let's throw hands. Oh, it's two of y'all? I can hurt one of y'all before y'all hurt me. And I thought I was a man. Till God set me down and said, man, you're a fool. You ain't no man. You're a fool. Because Taj, a lot of these things happened after I'd given my life to Christ. But the joy came when I realized that I was walking in sanctification. That there's some things that had to fall away. But it taught me a lot about other people. So if I'm like this, can I count wrongs against them? You got what I'm saying? If I got issues, can I be judging somebody else about their issues? Because God said, I'm loving. You're supposed to pray for them. He said, what is the gain if you love everybody that loves you? But how much more the gain? But see, that gain mean for the kingdom. Because God said, I came for those that are sick. I came for those that are all screwed up. And if you're me, where's your love? You know, the family members that you don't think should be in the family. Like, God says, I'm going to stop because it's 7:30. I ain't worried about what was left there. Listen to what God is saying. If you seek my kingdom and my righteousness, all things will be added unto you. Nothing will or can be withheld from you. He said, but my kingdom is love. Everything about my kingdom is love. When it was nothing but darkness, it still was about love. When I first started to create my plan for humanity, it was out of love. It was out of love. Can I have just a little music, please? Do we have anybody up there to give us a little music? Thank you. Thank you, Taj. Remember, repeat after me, please. Say, Brother Reggie, everybody in here need Jesus. As God speak to me, I'm just going to speak to you. Clear it up, Lord God. Satan, we renounce you. I decree that every stronghold that you have be destroyed right now. That there'll be freedom in this place. God say there's some people in here that have some beautiful hearts. Your hearts are beautiful. You're kind. You're loving. But the enemy of your soul, your adversary, have some things that he's gotten a grip on you with that frustrates you and anger you. But God says that's not who you are. That you're beautiful and you're wonderfully made. And his desire is that you be set free and that you have peace, that you have joy. Because the enemy is only trying to hold you down, to stop you from being who God has called you to be. because of you, you're responsible for a lot of souls. God want to use you to bring others to him. But here's the thing. The enemy doesn't want to release you. God says, I just want when they see you that they'll see me. God said, whatever it is, just give it to me and leave it there. Can't nobody in here throw rocks at anybody, especially me. Is there anybody in here that just needs a fresh start? You know the things that are weighing you down. Is there anybody here tonight that just want freedom and want love to abide in your heart? Just raise your hand if you want. I see you, my love. Is there anyone else? Under the bullshit, yeah. My brother, come here, bro. You, come here. I'm just going to tell you, man. There's a problem with you. And the problem is that you don't see you the way you need to see you. You don't see you the way God sees you. I've told you before that God said, cut the past away and let it go. But why are you still holding on to it? You don't have to tell me. See, you that guy that got a great heart. You're really like a big child, bro. I'm not being disrespectful. God say trust. Do you have a problem with trust, bro? You don't. You trust God. See, wait, what you just told me. Where you been? What did I tell you God told you to do? God told you to cut the password. Say, Father God, give me the strength to walk out of my past. Let me remember it no more. I thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Trusted him. But when I know, but when I whispered that in your ear, you're holding that thorn in your pocket. Throw it away. Throw it away, bro. You hear me? I'm not just telling you that. We got to throw it away. Because God said that you're okay with him in that area. You cried about that? God said when you cry, that was a form of repentance. Because he judged your heart. But he says now you're crying out about things that he don't remember anymore. Now I understand why he told me that you don't see yourself the way he sees you. Because he says that when you repent, he remembers your sins no more. Say, Brother Reggie, bro, I'm free. I just need to realize. I love you, brother. My sister, can I see you? need Sister Darnell, if you don't mind. I need my sister right here. I'm going to close this out, but I need y'all. I'm just following the Holy Spirit. I need y'all to minister to my sister. So I take it that everyone else here is good. Everybody's good? Father God, I come in boldness. Not in my strength, but I come based on your word. And I come against any and everything, Father God, just stopping her from getting up out of this wheelchair. Father God, it's not about my reputation because it's not me. I just want Satan to know that I stand on your word, that she's healed and she will walk according to her faith. And I'm bold enough, Father God, to say, I believe that you can do it. Because it won't be the first time and it won't be the last time. Father God, I don't care about what people think. All I know is that I believe your word. And Father God, I want you to know that I'll be anxiously waiting for her, Father God, to get up out of this wheelchair and walk in Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise God. Praise God. Why don't you stand up on your feet if you're able to? Praise God. Just continue to worship him. Lift your hands where you are. You don't have to leave here. Whatever you're in need of, you can receive it tonight. Glory to God. Praise God. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Tosh, just sing that chorus of Give Me Jesus. Is that the song? Yeah. Go to B flat and if you can sing that as we close here tonight. Glory to God. Glory to God. Just lift your hands and offer yourself to him as we close tonight on this chorus. Tonight.
You can have.
It doesn't mean anything to us tonight.
You can have
one more time. Give me Jesus. Tonight. Our prayer, Lord, is that you would continue to fill us with your love. Thank you for the revelation of your love tonight. It's the reason why you left heaven. It's the reason why you suffered, died. It's the reason why you were buried and raised from the dead. It's the reason why you ascended, but before ascending, you descended. Hell holding captivity captive. It's the reason why you're seated at the right hand of the throne of God, because of your love. And you said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only, that whosoever believeth in him would not perish. Father, your love cancels death. Your love cancels shame. Your love cancels
condemnation. Your love cancels fear. Your love, Father, cancels defeat. And we just thank you as we leave this place. Let us leave in the revelation, the full revelation of your love that not only draws us to you, but then helps us to love our brother, helps us to help our brother, our sister, helps us to lift up those that are downtrodden, helps us, Father, to take care of our brother and our sister. It's your love, Father, that upholds us, that comforts us, that secures us and surrounds us. And so we just thank you tonight for this word. We give you the glory. We give you the praise. In Jesus' name, somebody say, in Jesus' name, amen, amen. Clap your hands for the word that we received tonight. Glory to God. Praise you, Lord. Amen. Well, again, it's been great being with you tonight. Thank you, Coach Reggie. Thank you for that fresh, ready word. Love on somebody before you leave. It's great seeing you guys again, all those you come out under Coach's tenure. We just thank God for you tonight. Love on somebody before you leave. Be praying for Andrew. How long is your trip? How long is it? 2 weeks. So you leave Saturday and you come back 2 Saturdays after that. Okay, so we're going to be praying for you. We'll be praying over Gabby next week. All right. Love you. Hey, we'll see you this Sunday, 10 a.m.